Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to everyone present on that side. I am again welcoming you everyone on the Life Physics VK channel. So here we are again meeting on the behalf of the class 11th, and we are going to continue our third lecture after dealing with the second lecture. So you all know that in the second lecture, or you can say in the previous lecture, we talk about the units and measurement. So we started our next chapter, units and measurement, and we have dealt a little bit about that. Means we have discussed the small basic terms related to that chapter. And if I recall all these terms in a quick manner, these terms are, what are the quantity, means anything which is measurable to us, we call or we classify that into a category of quantity. And these measurable things means these quantity can be classified into two manners. Number one is the fundamental, or you can say the basic quantity, and number two is the derived quantity. Then we jump on to the next topic, that was the measurement. So we deal how the measurement is being done and what is the relevant formula for the measurement. After that, we enter into the next, we deal about the unit, we deal about the types of the unit, we deal about the systems of the unit, and the most important system that we are dealing presently is the SI system of the units. And at the end of that lecture, we have written all the SI units of these seven fundamental quantities. So if you remember that, so we have seven fundamental quantities and they have the SI units. So basically, what is the unit we have discussed? So unit, it is the representation, or it is a method in which we are going to indicate the fundamental quantity as a standard. So it is a way in which we are going to work on that. And since it is a standard, and in the previous lecture I used this word most of the time, standard, that we are going to measure this by comparing with the standard or by using the standard. So now the question arises, what is the standard? So basically, standard represents anything which should be common to everyone, which is common or which is same to everyone. It should not change from person to person, from place to place, or you can say from environment to environment. It should be common to everyone, it should be same to everyone. So SI means International System of Standard works on the same concept, that everyone can have the same definition of the unit. Everyone can have the same measurement of all the units. As I discussed, that if someone purchased a centimeter scale from the first shop, if you purchase the same centimeter scale from another shop, by another person, at any place which is being made up of any brand, it does not matter. That 15 centimeter always remain the 15 centimeter. So point is that how we can make such type of a standard. And in the starting of this, I'm going to discuss all these standards of these seven fundamental quantities. So we are here, we are going to do that. So we are going to discuss the SI units of what? Fundamental quantities. So we have seven fundamental quantities, and we are going to study the SI units of these seven fundamental quantities. We are not going to discuss about the derived, because derived quantities are always made up of, with the help of fundamental quantities. Kaise na kaise karke wo unhi se hi bante hain. So here we are with the fundamental quantities. So if you help me to recall, the first fundamental quantity that we discussed was length. Okay, so here we are going to discuss our first fundamental quantity. Fine, whose SI unit is? You have given me, or we have written earlier, and you know that, which is meter. Now we are going to define it. Define means, what is that standard definition of meter? So if I ask you, what is 1 meter? What is the definition of 1 meter? So previously in various classes, when I ask someone what is 1 meter, so most of the student gives me the various different types of the answer. Sir, 1 meter means 100 centimeter. Sir, 1 meter is equal to 1/1000 of the kilometer, means it is the 1/1000 part of the kilometer. Or they give me the answer in millimeter. So it is not a proper definition. It is not a definition. You are converting it. That's a 1 meter is equal to 100 cent. So you are giving me that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Or you can say, sir, when we combine 1000 meter, then it would be a 1 kilometer. So what is the standard definition for that? And SI gives us that standard definition. And what is the definition? So what is the meaning of 1 meter? So first of all, go with the definition, then I will explain that 1 meter, it is the distance covered by the light, covered by the light in time interval, in time interval of 1/2.99 × 10^8 seconds. So what is the standard definition of meter that has been given by the SI system? And that definition is, what is 1 meter? So 1 meter, it is that distance which is being covered by the light in the time interval of 1/2.99 × 10^8 seconds in vacuum. So what is 1 meter? So when you allow a light to pass through a vacuum, how much distance that light covers in 1/2.99 × 10^8 seconds? Itna time mein wo kitna distance cover karega? And that distance is being defined as 1 meter. So that is the standard definition of the 1 meter that the SI always used to calculate. And this definition is always being considered as the 1 meter distance. Or if any of the brand or any of the company is working, they always obey this if they are working in the SI system. And in this now, presently, most of the countries in the world work on the SI system, except some of the country. If I gave the example, America. Presently, the America, most of the places, it uses the FPS system. Okay, I know FPS system was developed by the Britain. So, वो हम लोगों ने discuss किया. But presently also, America deals with the FPS system, foot, pound and second. If you go to the America, in future, hope so. So if you go there and if you look on the roads, so here in India, on the road, if there is a distance of the Delhi Rewari, so on the board it has been mentioned Delhi 75 kilometer. So we use these meter and kilometer units. But on the other side, when we go in America, it would be written that distance of New York or Manchester or any city is 38 miles. They use a word miles, and mile is a larger unit of the foot. You all know that. Similarly, like kilometer is a larger unit of the meter. They use the mass unit pound instead of using the kg. So most of the student, the present on that side, I think you have seen, aap logon ne dekha hoga that WWE, World Wrestling Entertainment, aap log dekhte hain WWE, and when you hear that sound clearly, means when you see, hear that announcer who is mentioning the name of any XYZ wrestler to the ring, when he is inviting that wrestler, so he will mention that XYZ wrestler of mass 280 pound, 500 pound, or XYZ. So they use the word pound also. So the point is that presently America is working in the FPS. But there are more countries that are working in FPS, but majorities of countries are working in SI. So that's, and we are also the one of the part of that system. So that's why we have to work on the SI. So now the second, after the length, the second system is mass. Okay, the mass whose SI unit is kilogram, means kg. So what is 1 kg? So first of all, try to understand 1 kg. So 1 kg, it is the mass of a cylinder, means you can say prototype cylinder. So it is the mass of prototype cylinder made up of platinum, made up of platinum and iridium, whose diameter and height are equal. So what is 1 kg? So 1 kg, it is the mass of a cylinder. So we have a cylinder, prototype cylinder, a solid prototype cylinder, which is being made up of platinum and iridium. So it is made up of, or it is a mixture of platinum and iridium. But such type of cylinder whose diameter and whose height is equal. So whatever be the mass of such cylinder made up of platinum and iridium, whose diameter and height are equal, the mass of that cylinder would be always considered as 1 kg. And that is our standard. And this mass, if I gave a little bit information about this 1 kg, this 1 kg prototype cylinder, this has been preserved in the International Bureau of Weight and Measure in Paris. So you can know about a GK question that the International Bureau of the Weight and Measure, means the bureau which deals about the all the standards of the weight and measure, means the masses ke bare mein jo deal karta hai, that has been situated in the Paris. And in that, they have this as a prototype cylinder. वो उन्होंने वहाँ पे as a standard रखा हुआ है. So that's why, what is the 1 kg? So this is the definition of 1 kg. Now, we have dealt with the length, we have dealt with the mass. So now, we will deal with the third fundamental quantity, time. Time, whose SI unit is second, smallest. And if I ask you what is the definition of 1 second, means what time you can call as a 1 second. So we have to also define that 1 second also, because 1 second can't be say in an irregular manner. जैसे मैंने आपसे बात किया था, if you wear a watch which is pretty much costly of Reebok, 4,000-5,000 if you wear a watch which is very much costly as comparison to Reebok, like the Rolex, so they are in the lakhs also. So the point is that the cost is not of that time, the cost is not of that mechanism, the cost is always of that material of which the body or of which that watch has been made. So if you say any watch is made up of gold, they use a gold to make the watch or diamond, so that's why it become a very higher in cost. But it does not matter that the time would be fluctuating in all the watches, it is always being same, and it should be the same. Because if the time or any of the fundamental quantity which is not being a well defined or a standard, agar nahi hota hai, then it would create a problem. If we go in a journal and if we allow everyone that ki you can adjust your time according to yourself, agar main aap sabko hi bolu ki aap apne hisab se apne time ko set kar sakte, so in that manner there would be very much confusion in the time. Sabka watches alag alag speed se chalega. And how you can say in a simple language, if I ask you what is 1 second, if I share my one of the incident in the class initially when I asked, sir, what is 1 second? If someone, but that was in a joke manner, but it was, sir, 1 second means one. What is 1 second? The one. So this 1 second, if you are saying that 1 second, sir, ho gaya itne time mein, one mean the time in which I say the one, that is 1 second. This is not that proper answer. Some of you say, because if it happens, so everyone has a different way of speaking. If I say, what is 1 second? One. So this is my time. If someone gave, what is 1 second? one. Someone, let's suppose by default, he is not able to speak that much fast, तो थोड़ा सा रुक रुक के बोलता है. What is one second? One. So I think all the three students would have a different watch and they can't collaborate with each other in a proper time. So that's why the time should also be always been taken as a fundamental or basic and it should be well defined. So what is 1 second? It is the time duration. It is the time duration of 9.1 into 10 to the power 9 radiations in between hyperfine levels of cesium 133 happen. Okay, that would be very much new thing to everyone present on that side, and that might feel you to understand that concept a little bit, makes a little bit difficult. So what is 1 second? So if I gave you the overview, in the future when you are going to deal with the physics and later on, you will get to know about the concept of radiation and cesium 133 atom. But presently, if I gave you the basic idea, the cesium 133 atom emits the radiation because the levels on which the electrons of the cesium present, so they are in different levels. So in the atomic structure of the class 9th, or in chemistry you are dealing presently in the class 11th also, and you will deal agar nahi hua hai toh. So in that case we came to know that every atom ka apna ek orbit hota hai. But when you deal in the class 11th, you will came to know familiar soon as possible, aapko pata chalega that there are very fine energy levels, means electrons ke energy ke levels hote hai, very fine. Fine word means they are very close to each other, and in between those energy levels that electron is oscillating. That oscillation word is called as radiation. We call this as a radiation. So in those hyperfine means very close, so in between those very close energy levels that radiation is emitting. So what is the 1 second? So 1 second, it is that time, means in Hindi ये वो टाइम है जिसमें सीजियम 133 एटम के इलेक्ट्रॉन्स या रेडिएशन को एमिट होने में टाइम लगेगा. बट कितने रेडिएशन को? 9.1 into 10 की पावर 9 टाइम्स. इतनी बार वाइब्रेट करने में जो भी टाइम लगेगा, वी कॉल और वी टेक that time as a 1 second. So what is 1 second? ये वो time है जिसमें cesium 133 के atoms, sorry, इनके electrons, उनके hyperfine levels में 9.1 into 10 की power 9 times they oscillate, and that time interval is called as 1 second. So this is the definition of 1 second. So we have done the three quantities: length, mass, time. Number 4 quantity that we are going to work, and that 4th quantity you all know, that temperature. Okay, and the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin, symbol is capital. So now our question: what is 1 Kelvin? So what is the definition of 1 Kelvin? So 1 Kelvin, it is the fraction of 1 by 273.16. So it is the fraction of 1 by 273.16 of thermodynamic temperature of triple point of water. So what is 1 Kelvin? So 1 Kelvin, it is equal to 1 by 273.16 of thermodynamic temperature of triple point of water. So first of all, the new word for us in this definition is triple point. So what is triple point? That would be easily understood, and you will discuss sometime in chemistry and sometime in physics also you will be the when we'll study about the thermodynamic. So triple point, as its name, triple. So triple word means three. So triple point of the water means it is that temperature at which the water present in all the three states. Means it is that temperature at which we have the ice, we have the water state, and we have the vapor state. Means it is that temperature at which all the three states coexist with each other. Tino ek hi saath hoti hain. आपके पास आइस भी होगा, आपके पास वाटर भी होगा, और आपके पास वाटर वेपर भी होगा इन दैट स्टेट. दैट टेम्परेचर इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रिपल पॉइंट. और उस टेम्परेचर का कितना हिस्सा? 1/273.16. सो 1/273.16 टाइम्स ऑफ द ट्रिपल पॉइंट ऑफ द वाटर, दैट पार्ट इज नोन एज वन कैलोरी. सो हियर we started with the SI unit of the fundamental, so we are writing all the fundamental quantities, we are writing their SI unit, and the most important thing jisme main time laga raha hu, along with that we are also writing the definition. So we have done the four. So now it's been request, please first of all note it down all the four fundamentals quantities and their SI units definition. Please note it down. Now we have just three left and we will continue. Please note it down. Okay, since we have discussed these first four quantities, and now we are going to discuss the rest of the three quantities. Since we have the seven fundamental quantities, हमारे पास seven fundamental quantities है, and we are going to discuss all of them. So, okay now. So since we have discussed the first four, length, mass, time, and temperature. So our fifth one is current, and SI unit of current is ampere. And what is the definition of 1 ampere? Okay, so the definition of 1 ampere, I'm strictly restricting all of you, please do not go or do not recall that class 10th definition of 1 ampere that you have studied. What is 1 ampere? When 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second, that is called as 1 ampere. That definition of 1 ampere is totally wrong. Totally wrong. That definition is not been accepted by the SI system. Wo use accept hi nahi karta. So first of all, I want to discuss why that definition is wrong. So what was that in that definition? In that definition, it was 1 ampere means when 1 coulomb charge flows in 1 second. How much charge flows? 1 coulomb. And if you recall, in your class 10th, in that electricity chapter, the first question of your in-text book of your NCERT, that question was, how many number of electrons in 1 coulomb? 1 coulomb mein kitne number of electrons hai? And when you try to calculate, and you can try at your home now also, that would be 6 point something into 10 power 18. So now the point is that in 1 second, we are simply saying how much charge has to flow? 1 coulomb. That's the great thing. That's why in 1 second, we have to obey or we have to allow the 1 coulomb charge to flow. But now my question is, in reality, when you are saying that 1 coulomb charge is flowing, so now ask yourself, 1 coulomb charge flowing, what does it mean? How many number of electrons are flowing? You know the answer, 10 power 18. 10 power 18 number of electrons are flowing in 1 second. Can you do or can you access all the 10 power 18 number of electron in 1 second practically? क्या practically हो सकता है कि हम लोग हर electron के flow को study करें 1 second के अंदर? Means 1 second में you, when I say 1, if I say in a general 1 second, in 1 second 10 power 18 number of electron has been passed through the conductor. Can you study them practically? No. सो व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन एनी ऐसा यूनिट, जब भी हम किसी ऐसा यूनिट को डिफाइन कर रहे हैं, व्हेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन दैट यूनिट ऑफ दैट स्टैंडर्ड सिस्टम, दैट शुड बी प्रैक्टिकली डन, वो प्रैक्टिकली होना चाहिए, दैट शुड बी प्रैक्टिकली एसेसिबल, आप उसे कर सकते हैं, वो ऐसी डेफिनेशन होनी चाहिए, यू कांट से एनी रेंडम. सो दैट्स व्हाई इट्स अ रिक्वेस्ट दैट this definition was totally wrong and you will eliminate this definition from your mind. Okay, and what is the real definition of 1 ampere? The definition is, it is that amount of current flowing through two parallel wires separated by 1 meter and experience the force of attraction, or repulsion equal to 2×10⁻¹ newton per unit length. So this would be the new definition of 1 ampere that you are going to take as a standard definition. So ye hamara naya definition hoga. And how this definition has been derived, so at this time I am saying you that this definition you can easily verify. Out of these 7 definitions, 1 meter, 1, these are the practical demonstration based, but this definition, about this definition we can say that in the class 12, when we deal about a chapter called as a magnetic effect of electric current, then we can easily define this SI unit. So what is the SI unit of the current? So I am going with a quick manner that if we have two parallel wires, so if we have the two parallel wires separated by 1 meter, so take the two parallel wires and if they are separated by 1 meter, so both the wires carries the current, either they carries the current in same direction or either they carries the current in opposite direction, one goes up, one goes down, it does not matter, but if they are separated by 1 meter, then they will experience either force of attraction among them, so both the wire either attract each other or both the wire either repel each other. Why they do so? So these can be explained when we study that class 12 magnetic chapter. But they will attract or they will repel, and by how much amount? By 2×10⁻¹ newton, but per unit length. Means for unit length, for 1 meter length of that wire, they experience 2×10⁻¹ newton amount of attractive force or repulsive force if the two wires are separated by 1 meter. If the two wires do so, in that case, whatever be the amount of current flowing through both the wires, the current would be considered as 1 ampere. That is the actual definition of 1 ampere, because this can be practically performed. Aap ise practically kar sakte hai, not that 1 coulomb flows in 1 second. So that's why this is your real definition of 1 ampere. Now we have the 6th fundamental quantity, and that fundamental quantity is luminous intensity. SI unit, candela, symbol is CD. So what is 1 candela? So 1 candela, it is the luminous intensity. It is the luminous intensity of a radiation radiation in one direction of a radiation in one direction having frequency 540 into 10 power 12 hertz. So what is one candela? One candela word means, imagine that we have a source of radiation. Radiation means light. So radiation and light are both are the same thing. Please, in future we will prove or we will verify. Let's suppose you have a source of light, but as such a light who's having the frequency 540 into 10 ki power 12 hertz. So aapko ek aisa light chahiye jiska frequency 540 into 10 ki power 12 hertz ho. Okay? And we all know that when we switch on any light source, jab bhi aap kisi bhi light source ko switch on karte hain, what is the direction of flowing of radiation? Light kis direction mein jata hai? Your answer is, sir, it travels in all directions. So light will go in all the directions. So what is one candela? If we have a light source of this much frequency, then it will allow the radiation to flow in all directions. So we do not have to study the intensity of all directions. We have to take the intensity of light or intensity of that radiation in only one direction. So that intensity of radiation in one direction, that amount of intensity is called as one candela. इसे ही one candela बुलाते हैं. Means what is one candela? It is that intensity of a radiation in one direction whose frequency is 540 into 10 power 12 hertz. यानी इस फ्रीक्वेंसी की रेडिएशन सोर्स की इंटेंसिटी को वन कैंडेला बोलेंगे जब हम उसके केवल वन डायरेक्शन की इंटेंसिटी को डील करें. एंड दिस वन इज योर सिक्स्थ फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी. एंड द सेवेंथ वन एंड द लास्ट फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी इज योर व्हाट अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस. सो द लास्ट फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी इज amount of substance. SI unit, you know that, mole, so it would be mol symbol. And now we are going to study what is one mole. So one mole, it is the number of entities, or you can say elementary particles. So number of elementary particles present in 0.012 kg of, it is the number of elementary particles present in 0.012 kg of C12 atom. Means in that much amount kg means 0.012 kg of carbon 12 atom. Yani carbon 12 ke 0.012 kg substance le lijiye, usme jitne bhi number of entities honge jis bhi elementary particle ko aap padhna chahte hain, atoms or molecules, so unhi number of elementary particles ko hi kya bulate hain, one mole. And you know that, and you will deal in the chemistry that one mole is always been equal to 1.6 into 10 ki power, sorry, 6.06, sorry, 6.06 into 10 ki power 23. That are the number of mole. One mole contain how many number of elements? और ये आपका chemistry में बहुत बार repeat होने वाला है incoming. But this amount of substance is always been taken as the fundamental quantity. So here we have the rest of the three fundamental quantities: current, luminous intensity and the amount of substance. So here we are done with our today's lectures. So okay, lecture is not completed yet, but our today's lectures first section has been done. We have given the proper time, according to me we have given the proper time for definiting all the fundamental quantities according to the SI system. So four you have already noted down. Please note it down, these three also. And now we will discuss something related to a word that we discussed, was dimension. Please hurry up. Okay everyone, Since we have discussed about all the SI units of the fundamental 7 quantities, so we have discussed. So, in the lecture number 2, if you recall at the end, I discussed about the dimension 1. So, here we have 7 fundamental quantities. These 7 fundamental quantities are also called as the 7 dimensions of the world. As I called, you can remember similarly like the 7 wonders of the world. This is called as the 7 dimensions of the world. And these dimensions are, I am again writing, length, okay, whose does not have any relevant formula and its dimension is capital L. Means length is represented with a symbol of capital L. So dimension, it is just only the way of representing, but what is representing we will get to know. But let us talk about firstly about the all the fundamental. So length, then we have mass, it does not have any formula and its dimension representation is capital M. Then we have time, it also does not have any formula because these are always standard, its dimension is capital T. Then we have temperature, does not any formula, dimension representation is K. Then we have current, it does not have any formula. Now I know you have in a mind, sir, current has a formula from the class 10, I is equal to Q by T. But charge cannot be taken as the fundamental quantities. Current is taken, I have discussed in terms of that. मैंने बता दिया क्योंकि हम लोगों ने 1 एम्पियर क्यों डिफाइन किया ऐसे, नॉट इन दैट मैनर व्हेन 1 कूलम्ब चार्ज फ्लोज इन 1 सेकंड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू एसआई वी डू नॉट कंसीडर करंट एज अ डिराइव्ड, हम ये नहीं कहते कि करंट चार्ज से आया है, वी टेक द करंट एज अ फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी. ओके, अबाउट दैट करंट शुड बी द फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी और चार्ज शुड बी द बेसिक. ओके, इफ वी गो टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द करंट ऑफ योर क्लास 10, यू विल डेफिनेटली से सर चार्ज इज अ बेसिक क्वांटिटी, चार्ज है तो करंट है, मीन चार्ज से करंट डिराइव हुआ, चार्ज से करंट बनता है ना कि करंट से चार्ज बनता, दैट्स द ग्रेट थिंग. बट द सेकंड पॉइंट अबाउट द फंडामेंटल इज दैट डेफिनेटली वो चीज बिल्कुल बेसिक होनी चाहिए, उसी से आगे चीजें बननी चाहिए, मास से ही आगे कोई न्यू डेफिनेशन. बाय यूजिंग द मास, बाय यूजिंग द टाइम और बाय यूजिंग द लेंथ वी कैन डिफाइन द फर्दर मोर क्वांटिटीज, हम इनकी हेल्प से आगे डिफाइन कर सकते हैं. बट करंट के केस में उल्टा चल रहा है, चार्ज से करंट आता है, करंट से चार्ज नहीं आता है, दैट्स द करेक्ट थिंग. बट देयर शुड बी वन थिंग अबाउट द फंडामेंटल और द बेसिक क्वांटिटी इज दैट दैट क्वांटिटी शुड बी वेल डिफाइंड, शुड बी प्रैक्टिकली अप्रोचेबल, दैट शुड बी इन दैट मैनर. बट अबाउट द 1 एम्पियर द प्रॉब्लम दैट आई डिस्कस दैट व्हेन वी से 1 कूलम फ्लोज इन 1 सेकंड, दिस कांट बी प्रैक्टिकली अटेनेबल. सो If you go into the Google search, आपको बहुत सारे ऐसे conclusions और बहुत सारे ऐसे contradiction statement मिलेंगे. There are some physicists which say that the Coulomb should go with that because Coulomb is responsible for the current. Some says because of that practical evidence, they will say no current should be. So when you go into the Google search, you will get the contradiction or there is a war which has been gone. बहुत पहले चला था. When we discuss about that in 1916 that SI was came into that action and at that time that war was on the way on the hypersheet. War बहुत चला था कि कूलम होना चाहिए और should be current. So ये एक contradiction part था. But SI chooses the current as a fundamental. So we will go current as a fundamental. आपके दिमाग में वो doubt आना लाजमी है. But I discuss or I mention that why we are not taking charge. So current, its dimension is capital. Then we have what? Luminous intensity. Luminous intensity. This is also being taken as a fundamental. His dimension is CD, candela. Then last is your amount of substance. Amount of substance. SI unit is mole and its dimension is MOM. So here the 7 fundamental quantities with their dimension formula means with their representation. So these are called as a 7 dimension. But there, here I have written the dimension formula. So we are going to discuss one definition, and that definition is dimension of physical quantity. Physical means now I am focusing on the derived quantity. Basically or importantly, वैसे in physical quantity means anything which is measurable or a simple quantity, fundamental also come and derived also come. So we have talked about the fundamental earlier, पहले भी लिखा था, again I have written, but let's talk about the derived. So what is the dimension? So basically it is the method to show that with which power or you can say exponent, the fundamental quantity is used to derive other quantity. I think you have clear with the definition, but what is the definition of the dimension of physical quantity? It is the method. It is the simply method to show that or to represent that with which power, means how many times, means how, what should be the power, or you can say the exponent of any fundamental quantity to represent or to calculate any derived quantity. For an example, if I say area of rectangle. So what is the area of rectangle? It is length into width. So length into width. So what is being used as a fundamental in area? So in area आपने क्या use किया? You use a length. So length is a fundamental quantity. Done. Second thing, what do you use? Sir, we use a width. But width or breadth, what you call that width or a breadth is type of length. Width भी तो एक तरीके से length ही है. Means the SI unit of width you also take as a meter. So length is a meter, means the length, and width is also a meter, means it is also been a length. So to calculate the area, we use which quantity? We use length as a fundamental quantity. And how many times we use? We use 2 times. So this dimension method help us to indicate that any physical quantity, any derived quantity, किसी भी fundamental quantity को कितनी बार use करता है. So area use length, fundamental quantity 2 times, length, width. But does the area use the mass? No. Does it use the time, temperature, current, luminous amount? No. So it uses the length only 2 times. So it represent that much. In similarly manner, help me out. If I want to calculate volume, so volume has a formula, length into width into height. So length into width into height. So length is length. Width is also like a fundamental length. Height, it is also a length because all have a meter quantity. So in volume, we use what? Or which fundamental quantity we use? We use length. And how many times we use? We use 3 times. And that formulation, we use the length in a 3 times, this representation is called as dimension, or simply we call as a dimension formula. So here we are going to do at the end the dimension formula for various physical quantities. So we are going to work on that, but before that I again personally want, please note it down, all the 7 fundamental quantities along with their dimension, and please note it down the definition in a quick manner. Hurry up please. Okay, now since we have done this, so now we are going to work on the which we are going to work on derived quantity. So here we are going to work on the derived quantity, and let's start with the, so there are various derived quantity jo aapko work karna hai. I will only discuss some of them, and rest of will be your homework jo aap log khud karenge. So the first, as I discuss about area, so formula for the area, length into width. Length, it is L, width, it is also L. So since both are L, so it would become L square. Am I clear with the dimension formula for area? So what is the dimension formula for area? L square. L square represents you what? L square means dimension formula. It is not any formula jo hum log calculation mein use karenge. Please, I am clearly again. It is not the formula. This is your basic formula that you will use to calculate any numerical value. But what is that formula? I am again repeating. Dimension formula, it is the method of representing. It is only the method of representing that how many times means with what power and which fundamental quantity that you are using to define that derived quantity. Means area ko define karne ke liye aapne kaun si fundamental ko use kiya aur kitni baar use kiya. That is the dimension formula. So do not get confused with the formula. Formula is different thing, dimension formula is the different thing. So now we will go in a quick manner. Volume. Formula is length into width into height. So it would be L into L into L. So I will go in a quick manner. L cube. Clear? Similarly, please. Let's help me out in velocity, please. Velocity, or you can say speed. Numerically. So velocity is equal to displacement upon time. What is displacement? L. And time is T. Means L divided by T, so it would be L T minus 1. When this T goes up, its power would be minus 1. It shows you have used the length one time. It shows you have used the time one time. But length power is, sorry, time power is minus 1. It indicates that you have used the time in the rate. Means aapne use reciprocal mein use kiya. So the dimension formula for, you can say velocity, or you can say speed, is L T minus 1. Similarly, acceleration, or simply you can also call acceleration due to gravity. They're both are the same thing. So acceleration is equal to velocity by time. We all know that. And velocity dimension has been already made. It is Lt minus 1 by t. So it would be Lt minus 2. Clear? Lt minus 1. This was the dimension for what? This was the dimension for velocity we have already made. And whichever the be the dimension jo aap already pehle bana chuke, you can use that thoroughly. Aap use wapas se use kar sakte by t. It would be Lt minus. So acceleration, or you can say acceleration due to gravity. Let's help me out in density. Okay? And what is the formula for density? Mass by volume. So what is your mass here? Mass dimension, it is a fundamental. But volume dimension is L cube. So what would be the dimension? ML minus 3. So this would be the dimension of your fifth quantity, which is your density. Similarly, help me out. Force. Force is a formula. Mass into acceleration. So mass. And what is the dimension for acceleration? LT minus 2. So what is the dimension of force we got? MLT minus 2. Similarly, next, pressure. What is the formula for pressure? Force upon area. Force MLT minus 2 divided by area. It has been your L square. And when you solve it, you will get ML minus 1 T minus 2. So this is the dimension of your pressure. So here the seven derived quantity that I have done, and in the same manner we have to go with the various dimensions formula. Hame wo use kar rahe hain, because in this chapter the dimensions formula are going to be the key part while solving this. And since presently I know that aapke dimag mein aa raha hoga, sir, if it is a simply representation, it is not the formula, to why we are dealing with this dimension formula? Agar ye keval representation hai, तो हम लोग इसे इतना ज्यादा टाइम एंड व्हाई वी आर स्पेंडिंग दैट मच एफर्ट ऑन दैट यू विल गेट टू नो इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर दैट व्हाट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ डीलिंग विद द डायमेंशन को पढ़ने का बेनिफिट क्या है. you will get to know about this, but in the next lecture. But before that, we are going to gather our all the dimensions quantity. So here the 7 I have done. The rest of, I will write the name, I will write the formula, the purpose, mean the dimension formula, you will do by your own. ये आपको अपने आप gather करना है. And I am writing all those dimensions here. So 7, 8, we are going to write all this manner. So after pressure, you have, okay, one thing more that I left, force is also called as tension. So remember that. So since we have done on that, so now we are going to work on all the dimensions जो आप लोगों को gather करना है. Okay? So here we have momentum. Momentum whose formula is mass into velocity. So we are going to work on all those quantities. Then your work done is equal to force into displacement. Then your kinetic energy is half mv square. Okay, here we have half is a constant, and constant does not have any unit, and if it does not have any unit, it would not have any dimension. So yani half ka koi dimension nahi hoga, m mass ka dimension hoga, velocity ka dimension. So mean dimension keval unhi cheezon ke ho sakte hain jo fundamental ko use karte hain, jinka koi unit hota hai. Half, it is not using any of the fundamental, so it would be dimensionless. So remember that part. Potential energy, 11th please, जो आप लोग बना के देंगे. Potential energy, the formula is mgh. Okay, now we will study some new terms जो आप लोग 11th class में पढ़ते जाएंगे. Surface tension, its formula is force per unit length. Then we have stress, its formula is also force per unit area, restoring force per unit area, but presently you can write as a force per unit area. Then we have strain, it is being defined as change in length by original length. Change in length, what is the change in length divided by original length? So you have to check out by your own. Aap apne try karenge khud se. Then we have Young's modulus of elasticity, and that formula is stress that you derive on the 13 divided by the strain जो आप लोगों ने यहाँ किया. Then our 16. After this, जितना भी अभी हम लोग कर चुके हैं, so we will continue with that. We have one more, impulse. Okay, and its symbol is J. And impulse has a formula that you would be your force into time. Means for what interval of time आप लोग force कितनी देर के लिए लगा रहे हैं. Okay. Then we have 17th. Okay, it would be lack of the space. So now everyone, so first of all, note it down, all the 7 you have to draw or you have to note it down in the table form. And I am requesting that the rest of the quantities that I am writing, rest of the derived quantity jo main yahan likh raha hu, you have to write the definition, formula and the dimension similarly in the table form. आपको टेबल की फॉर्म में करके इसे रेडी रखना है. सो दैट्स योर वर्क. सो आई एम रबिंग हियर नाउ. सो वी हैव डन अप टू 16 क्वांटिटीज, जिनमें से 7 तो मैंने किया था. सो नाउ 17th, ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट, विच वॉज योर कैपिटल जी. ओके, its formula is fr square by m1 m2. So you have to do this. Okay, done. Then we have power. power has a formula, work done upon time. So what was the dimension of work done? That you have done in the night, then by time. So you can do by hour. Then we have torque. So torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. So this R represents the distance, and this will represent your what force. So it would be torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Then we have discussed about the angle we have to discuss. So theta, from the class 11th you have studied, theta has a formula, length of arc divided by radius. So what would be the dimension of angle? Then we have next term, frequency, from the class 9th. The frequency has a formula, 1 upon time period. So what is the formula for the frequency? You will calculate. Number 2, 22, there would be a constant called as Planck's constant. You will heard about, or you are going to get to know about this constant in your chemistry recent started chapter, structure of atom mein aapko sunne ko milega. And that Planck's constant jo aap logo ko padhna hai, and that is your energy divided by frequency. So you will also calculate the dimension for the Planck's constant. Okay, 23, this is your pressure gradient. Pressure gradient, it is, the formula is, its formula is pressure per unit length. So pressure gradient, pressure per unit length. So here we are going, or here I have given 23 physical quantities, 23 derived quantities which can use directly. Kuch jagah pe directly use ho rahi hai, kuch jagah pe indirect way you are using any of the fundamental quantities aap use kar. But at this starting, in the all the possible case, you will check to know, or you will get to know, that we are mostly using either length, either mass, or either time. So we are totally mostly focusing on mass, length, time. Means majority of quantities mein mass, length, time repeated hota hai. Temperature, current, luminous, and amount of substance, these are very much occasional. So we will study about those also. But presently, it's my humble request at the starting stage to everyone that we have to work on only on those physical quantities jo hum log already either 9th or 10th mein deal kar chuke hain, or either we will continue. So here we have only 23 jo maine aapke samne rakhi hain. Okay, so first of all, note it down, these 23, by pausing the video, please note it down. There are some more that I want to write, aur fir uske baad hum log aage work karenge. Yeah, please note it down. Okay, after this there are some more, since we are discussing about the pressure gradient. So there we have velocity gradient. It would be velocity per unit length. Now I want to add something from the aspect from the electrical department. So charge, what is the dimension of the charge? That you have to remember. And since, as I told you, we are going to use this formula, current is equal to charge per unit time. So charge would be current into time. So what is the formula for the charge? Current into time, and the dimension of current is A and time is T. So I am writing it because it is a new thing. So what is the dimension of the charge? It is your AT. Similarly, you will find out the electric potential. Now you have to recall your class 11, sorry, class 10th, electric potential, work done per unit charge. Then you have to find out what? Resistance. R is equal to V upon R by using the Ohm's law. V is equal to IR, so R is equal to V upon R. Then you have to give me the resistivity. Rho is equal to what? R into A by L. R is equal to rho L by A. So you can use the formula for resistivity from here. So these are the small terms jo abhi tak aap logo ko karna hai. These are the 28 terms means 28 physical quantities, but at the end of this video I'm saying you after 28 just left 10 more space, 10 more columns ko left karenge aap log, so that in future when we go on to the numerical, jab bhi hum log inke numericals pe jayenge, might be we get to know some more new physical quantities as per the definition. So as per the definition, kya pata hume koi naya quantity aur mil jaye. So for that we have to ready presently now. So these are the general 28 jo maine likha hai. इसके अलावा 10 स्पेस आप लोग लेफ्ट करेंगे, सो 10 कॉलम्स छोड़ के चलना, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो. सो दिस इज द थिंग दैट वी हैव टू डन इन द लेक्चर नंबर 3 दैट वी हैव डन अबाउट द ऑल द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ द एसआई एंड द डायमेंशन. सो आई हैव ड्रॉन द डायमेंशन फॉर द फर्स्ट 7, रेस्ट ऑफ इट इज योर होमवर्क, यू हैव टू डू बाय योर ओन. इफ यू फाइंड एनी डाउट you can ask me anytime. You all have my contact number. आप सबके पास contact number है. You can WhatsApp me personally or you can either ask me on the comment box में भी YouTube पे आप पूछ सकते हैं. Please ask more and more doubt. That shows us कि आप लोग lecture से go through जा रहे हैं. Okay, now there are one or two things that I heard or that I got a message from your site. So I will just take only 2 minutes. And that thing is that you are saying that sir, video is the little bit lengthy, means you are making the video of 1 hour 10 minutes 1 hour 15 minutes. But I want to say something to everyone present on that side. Presently we have to understand the situation of every subject. Every subject works on a different manner. I'm not saying that any ye wala subject low hai, ye wala subject high hai. Every subject has a different level. Sab subject apni jagah pe important. But the difference in all the subject is the technique. You have to try to understand, if I am taking 1 hour, agar main aapka 1 ghanta liya maine is video mein, so by the end of this video please listen up. If I take the 1 hour, we have done the work. If I am going to write, I am writing everything on the board, we are discussing everything, we are discussing each and every small point. So you have to hear, aapko sunna padega. It is your lecture. It is not the demonstration part that I go here and in the next 20 minutes, 30 minutes mein maine sara cheez likh diya and I say please note it down. And then you will face the difficult. So that's why I'm trying to explain everything. That's why little bit mera videos ya lectures are going to be little bit lengthier, but try to focus on that. And how much time that I'm taking? Only 1 hour 15 minutes here. And if we have an interest in anything, अगर हम मूवी भी देखते तो वो भी 2 hours 3 hours का होता है. आई नो दैट इज मूवी, बट व्हाई वी आर नॉट गेट बोर्ड, बिकॉज वी फील इंटरेस्ट इन दैट. दैट्स व्हाई आई एम गोइंग टू ट्राई टू क्रिएट द इंटरेस्ट, बिकॉज दिस इज द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द क्लास 11th एंड आई और वी रिक्वायर्ड अ मोर टाइम टू कॉन्टेक्ट विद ईच अदर. सो प्लीज विद दैट नोट गो थ्रू द वीडियो थरली, नोट इट डाउन एवरीथिंग एंड डू योर होमवर्क. थैंक यू वेरी मच. वी विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.